Okay, this is a system that in another video we solved by using substitution. It was 3x plus y equals negative 14. And in this particular problem, it was pretty easy to solve for y. So we went around, did the substitution and back substitution, and we got negative 4 and negative 2 for the solution. This problem could also be done by substitution. It's sort of natural because it's in the form ax plus by equals c, so you sort of have your x terms and your y terms lined up on the left. Now, if you're looking at the x terms, one's 3, one's 4, what you could do is multiply the top by 4 and the bottom by negative 3 to get the least common multiple of 12, so one will be positive 12 and negative 12. But actually, it's easier to eliminate the y's here because I have a y and a 3y, so that's really a 1y. In the top equation. So if I multiply the top by negative 3, then I'll have a negative 3y and a positive 3y. So here's how you do the same problem using the addition method. Multiplying the top equation by negative 3 and doing nothing with the bottom equation, I have negative 9x minus 3y equals positive 42. It's very important to remember to multiply a negative 3 by the negative 14. It's a common mistake, only multiplying it on the left side. In the bottom, I'm not going to multiply by anything. I'm just going to copy it down again and then go ahead and add on the left negative 5x. On the right, you get 20 divided by negative 5. So x is going to be negative 4. So it looks like negative 4 is the x term. And the x coordinate, excuse me. Now that we know that x is negative 4, I go back to either equation to solve for y. So let's take the second equation. It doesn't matter which equation you put it in. So we're going to put in negative 4 for x. Simplify the left side. Add 16 to both sides. And we get 3y is negative 6. Divide by 3, and we get negative 2. So the value of y is also negative 2. So we get the same answer, right? Now, you would still check that negative 4, negative 2 is a solution to the first equation, the first original equation, 3x plus y equals negative 14, and 4x plus 3y equals negative 22. We did that previously when we did it by substitution, so here's the check into both of the original equations so that we know negative 4, negative 2 really is the correct solution. Sometimes you have to multiply the top equation and the bottom equation by something because it won't work just to multiply the top equation by something like in this particular instance. So it depends. Every single problem is different. Sometimes you already have a 3x and a negative 3x and you don't have to multiply the top equation or the bottom equation by anything. You simply add up. The other two things that might happen is when you add, you'll either get a true equation or a false equation. And again, anytime you get a true equation like 5 equals 5, that's the dependent solution. They were the same line, and infinitely many solutions would be your answer to that. Anytime you get a false equation like 5 equals 8, it would be no solution. Going back to our first example, I want to point something out. When we solve this system by the addition method, which is definitely the easiest method to solve this by, we have 4 negative 1/5. If you try doing this by graphing, it would be really hard to estimate where that order pair was that those two lines crossed at. But if you had a perfectly accurate graph, that is the point where those two lines would intersect at 4 negative 1/5. So remember, you can always check this graphically, but graphically is sort of the least accurate because it's hard to be that perfect. Same thing for this problem. If you graph those two lines, it would cross at negative 4 and negative 2, But to be honest, graphing those lines is not so easy. 4x plus 3y equals negative 22. The y-intercept is not at an integer, for instance. So it would be really difficult to do this by graphing. So these algebraic methods, doing it by substitution, as in this case, or in addition, usually it's a little bit easier to come up with a solution. All right, here's another system of equations we're going to solve by using the addition method. Now, notice these two would be difficult to graph and find the point of intersection because they don't go at nice x and y intercepts. And also, using the substitution method, it's not so simple to solve for x or y. You would have fractions. So this is a perfect example where you'd want to use the addition method. So we need to either eliminate the x terms or the y terms. You could do it either way. Let's begin by eliminating the x terms because all we need to do is multiply the bottom equation by negative 2 so that we have 4x in the top one, negative 4x in the bottom one. So what does that give us? This implies, well, we're not multiplying the top by anything, so we just got to write that one down again, 4x minus 2y equals 5. And at the bottom, we have negative 4x minus 6y equals negative 8. Remember to multiply all terms on each side by negative 2, and be careful with your positive and negative signs. All right, on the left side, the x's cancel, so we now have negative 8y equals, well, 5 minus 8 is negative 3. Yep, that's what we're going to get. We're going to get a fraction. Didn't do anything wrong. Fractions are numbers too. So we have to divide both sides by negative 8. And we've got that the y value is 3/8. Now, normally what we do is go back to one of the original equations, plug in 3/8 for y, and then solve for the other variable. But you know what? That's not a lot of fun because we have this fraction to plug in for y, and then we're going to have to deal with fractions. So it's actually easier to find your x coordinate, the value of x, by doing the problem and again eliminating the y values so you'll be able to solve for y. So we do know what y is, right? We're going to have part of the ordered pair so far. Now we're going to take the same original two equations, 4x minus 2y equals 5 and 2x plus 3y equals 4, and let's multiply them each by something so that the y values are going to be opposites. So hopefully you'll notice that between 2 and 3, the least common multiple is 6. So if I multiply the top by 3 and the bottom by 2, I'll have a negative 6y in the top plus 6y at the bottom. There's no room for me to write it next to it, so I'm going to write them underneath here. So this equation becomes 12x minus 6y equals 15, and 4x plus 6y equals 8. So let's see, if we add both sides, we have 16x equals 23, divide by 16, and there's my x-coordinate. My x-coordinate is going to be 23/13. So I've got x is 23/16, y is 3/8, and notice you can just use the addition method twice, first solving for x, second time solving for y, by eliminating the different variable each time, get your answer. But it'll work if you would have just plugged in 3/8 for y into either of the original two equations and solved for x. You would have gotten 23/16 that way as well. Now, when it comes to checking, you're stuck. You're going to have to deal with fractions by just making sure when you plug in those values for x and y, you do get a true equation. All right, so we're going to have to check the ordered pair in each equation. So in the first equation, 4x minus 2y equals 5. We're putting in 23/16 for x and 3/8 for y. So I can cancel here the 4 and the 16, and that gives me 23/4 minus. And let's see, the 2 and the 8 cancel, minus 3 fourths, which is 20 fourths, or 5. So, hey, awesome. That checks because there was 5 on that side. And then we'll check it in the other equation, 2x plus 3y equals 4. 2 goes into 16. 8 times, so I'm going to get 23 eighths. Now, since I've got it in terms of eighths, I'm going to keep this in eighths. Well, it doesn't cancel anyway. Plus 9 eighths, which is 32 eighths. And 32 divided by 8 is 4. And there's 4 on that side. So 23 sixteenths is the correct solution to our system. And there you go.